Well, good day! So for today, I would like to go back and talk about the original Spider-Verse, and more specifically, about that classic misunderstood villain who is all green. That is correct, I'm talking about the Lizard! He's a pretty fantastic guy with a pretty fantastic story, so let's check it out! Alright, let's go!
Yeah!
So, we start off in the Florida Everglades, where there are two friends who are having a wonderful, relaxing day just fishing,
when suddenly,
a frickin' lizard man pops out of the water, flips their boat, and tells those guys to beat it. The swamp is his territory after all, you know. So these freaked out fishermen do just that, man. They take off. Gone. The news of this lizard attack hits the Daily Bugle in New York City, and Spider-Man wants to get a closer look at this lizard man, right? So Spider-Man, in the persona of Peter Parker, gets the help of Betty Brant to convince J. Jonah Jameson to send Peter down to Florida, you know, so he can get some photos of this lizard person for the paper. It's a pretty worthwhile news story after all, right? And on the side, you know, Spider-Man can take a looky-loo at what's going on with this lizard kind of stuff. And Jameson agrees. So, once Peter gets down to the Sunshine State, he goes to the laboratory of reptile researcher Dr. Curtis Connors to get the lay of the land and try to get some initial answers. And while Peter is on the way to the laboratory, this lizard man catches up with him and tries to stop Spider-Man, because apparently he's gonna find out everything that's going on, and he don't want that. So Spider-Man quickly, easily, and quite literally kicks the lizard's butt.
But
Spider-Man eventually makes it safely to the laboratory, where he meets up with Dr. Connors' family, right? There is Dr. Connors' son, Billy, and his wife, Martha. And it turns out that the good doctor left a note for Martha saying that, you know, something bad has happened to him. She should take Billy and just, like, split, like, take off. Which is, you know, kind of a cryptic and, like, concerning and depressing letter. So Martha is, you know, kind of not in a good state of mind, you know, obviously, right, at this point. But she does mention to Spider-Man that Dr. Connors was working on a cure for swamp fever. So Spidey decides to take a look into Dr. Connors' laboratory, see if he can get some answers, you know, as to where the doctor is and, you know, I guess snoop, you know, for things. And with a peruse through the laboratory, Spidey discovers that Doc Connors created a formula for Capsicum Reptilius, which is not good at all, man. This formula turns people into lizard people. So Spidey realizes, like, holy crap, man, I've got to make an antidote for this because this is not good. The lizard breaks into the lab and, you know, tells Spider-Man that indeed he intends to use this formula on the general population and turn all humans into lizard people, where then the lizard will rule all these new lizard people as the Lizard King. Why they would automatically follow him as their king, you know, who knows, but you know, it kind of makes sense to his lizard mind, I guess. And then, to stop Spidey in his tracks, the lizard throws in a German World War II era grenade. Blows up parts of the lab, you know, pretty good. But Spidey emerges unscathed, and he has the antidote. Spidey goes after the lizard and catches up with him in some abandoned Spanish, you know, fort, I guess, somewhere's in there. He does a quick little tussle with the lizard again, where he does manage to get the lizard all tied up, and then he lovingly shoves this antidote down the lizard's throat, where he transforms into Dr. Connors. So it turns out that this swamp fever serum was, like, total bunk, no good at all, and instead of curing the fever, it turned Doc Connors into that dreadful lizard. But that's all good now, that's in the past, right? Dr. Connors is cured, he's reunited with his family, and Peter Parker has photos of the lizard for J. Jonah Jameson at the Bugle, right? So all is good.
Or is it?
J. Jonah Jameson rejects the photos. He says that there is no lizard person because some movie studio was filming a lizard movie at the time in the area,
and this must have been a publicity stunt.
Yep, you're right again, JJ. And with that, Well, that is the end of this spectacular tale.
So yeah, like that was actually a pretty awesome little episode, right? You know, like, I remember being a kid watching this episode, and this particular one always felt kind of different, you know, as opposed to the other Spider-Man episodes. You know, there was something kind of about it, like, it seemed a bit more serious, and it seemed like it had kind of a different tone to it. I'm not sure if that was just me or not. Like, I guess in one respect, you know, Spider-Man actually leaving New York City to go fight a supervillain. Well, you know, like, in this first season anyway, you know, in subsequent seasons, he went to different Earths and different dimensions and stuff like that. But, you know, if we're talking Earth locales, yeah, man, it's usually all in New York or this, you know, Florida, right? Well, in New York City for the most part, if we're talking about Earthbound stories. But also, like, the Lizard, there was something else about it, right? You know, like, how he's not quite the exact same kind of caliber of villain, like, you know, Electro or the Rhino or Sandman or something like that, right? In this show, man, like, a lot of villains didn't really have a fleshed out backstory in the, well, in the cartoon. In the comics, they might have, you know, but in this cartoon series, you know, they're not quite one-dimensional, you know, but still, there's really not much behind what they're doing. But, like, for the Lizard, right, he seems kind of different. He seems more kind of humanized, you know, because there is that backstory kind of fleshed out with him in the show, right? Like, you meet his wife, you meet his son, they're all really distraught about Dr. Connors, they're really worried, you know, and it's not really Spider-Man punching a villain in the face, you know, leaving a note for the police and then swinging off, you know. No, man, he's actually trying to help the villain this time, right? So yeah, when this show was up in reruns as a kid watching it, I was always like, oh yeah, this is that kind of really neat episode, you know, that kind of differenter one. Well, the ones that was still based on Earth, because like I say, there's other ones, man, when he went to different dimensions, man, those were, yeah, those were pretty crazy. And in watching this episode as an adult, I can't help but feel that same kind of vibe from the movie The Fly. Not The Fly with Sexy Goldblum or anything, no, no. I'm talking about the original one with Vincent Price. Like, there are some story beats that are kind of similar, right? Like, there's a husband who's a scientist and he's working on an experiment and it all kind of goes awry and it transforms his body. And his family is all like, oh, secure, sacre bleu, you know? I only speak en français there because, you know, it was in Montreal. Of course, the cartoon had much more of a happier ending, you know, than the movie. But, you know, there is some kind of a similar vibe to it, at least to me. Not sure if you feel the same way or not, but, you know, it is what it is, right? But, yeah, that's, you know, my thoughts on the whole thing. Yeah, let me know your thoughts on it. You know, if I'm hip and happening with what I'm saying, or if you, you know, see something else that I didn't see, or whatever, man. Like, there's that chat stuff down below. But, yeah, man, I do have some other behind-the-scenes kind of things and all that kind of stuff, so let's go take a look at that stuff over here. Alright, so let's just take a closer look at this Lizard guy here, okay? So, the Lizard first appeared in The Amazing Spider-Man number 6 in 1963. And the story from that comic was basically the exact same story that you've seen in this featured episode. Well, you know, mostly anyway. So, like, the main points of the story are pretty much the same, right? Like, you had a Lizard Man attacking people in the Florida Everglades. Spider-Man goes down to Florida after Peter Parker convinced J. Jonah Jameson, you know, that he should go down there. Spidey meets with, you know, the Connor family. He learns that Doc Connors had some crazy experiments going and it affected him into a lizard person, where Spidey eventually made an antidote and saved him, right? Like, all that stuff is the same, so it's, you know, the same story, right? Well, you know, maybe not for the, you know, fine details and stuff, right? So, right off the bat, if you didn't know, you know, it's a pretty obvious kind of difference. In the comic books, Doc Connors only has one arm. He is missing his right arm, right? He was a surgeon in the army, and in a war that he was in, he lost his arm. So since then, he has been trying to unlock the reptilian secrets of being able to regrow a missing limb. So he has been experimenting on that, and eventually on himself, right? So yeah, his arm grew back, but he also turned into this lizard. Just went a bit too far. So the motivation for his lizard-like work, you know, made sense, and it all makes complete sense as to why he turned into a lizard person, right? Whereas, in the cartoon featured episode, Doc Connor absolutely has both of his arms. He was not trying to look for a lizard regeneration serum or anything. He was trying to find a cure for swamp fever. Now, not too quite sure, you know, the ins and outs of swamp fever, but not quite sure how a serum for that would turn someone into a lizard per se.
But it is what it is, man. You know, he must have put too much benazine in the concoction, I guess, or something. Made his teeth chatter. Also, in the comic book, Martha Connors knew absolutely full well that Doc Connors turned into the lizard, you know, and she was really worried about him, and that's why she didn't leave. Which kind of goes with the whole notion of what I was saying earlier about how, you know, this character is much more humanized than other Spider-Man villains. You know, right? Because Spidey's not just fighting a villain, he's trying to save a family, you know? You don't really get that at first, you know, with the cartoon, because Martha had no idea what happened to her husband and why this lizard person is suddenly, you know, showing up and terrorizing them, right? Definitely puts a different spin on things. These are some of the finer details, which are actually kind of big details, you know, but still, like, the main meat and potatoes of the whole story is the same from the comics, so, you know, good on them, right? But, you know, even the look of the lizard is the same, right? You know, he's got his fancy white lab coat, his black shirt and purple pants, looks like a rock star, and of course, the lizard is a classic Steve Ditko design, you know, Steve Ditko being the original artist of Spider-Man and all his early villains. So, like, a really good look, you know, with the, you know, human-shaped kind of head just lizardized a bit, you know, looking kind of different there. The shape of the lizard's head and his body and all that stuff has changed over the years, you know. A more popular kind of look of the character is the lizard being portrayed with a full elongated maw, you know, like you'd see with, like, dinosaurs and stuff. Sometimes his arms are longer, or he has a more kind of crouched down look to him or whatever, but, you know, at the end of the day, man, he's a lizard man, you know? And a lizard being, you know, a classic Spider-Man villain, he's appeared in pretty much every single Spider-Man cartoon there has been, you know, every video game, toys, whatever, right? Like, really, he is a pretty awesome character, so, you know, you gotta see him around. And it seemed to take quite a long time for us to finally see a live-action version of the lizard in the Sam Raimi Spider-Man movie series, which started in 2002. We did see Dr. Connors, and he was more of a professor and a mentor to Peter Parker, you know, while he was at university, which is pretty nice to see those characters kind of together. But Doc Connors did not transform into the lizard in those movies. But he was at least depicted more comic accurate with, you know, having a missing right arm. But, you know, fast forward a little bit, and we finally did see the lizard in his lizard form in the Amazing Spider-Man movie in 2012. This time, Dr. Connors did indeed take the reptile regeneration experimental formula and did transform into a terrifying humanoid lizard man for the first time on film. You know, whether you really like the look of the character or not in that one, you know, it's still pretty cool to finally see this character in live action. So yeah, good. And you know, we'll still definitely see this character a lot more. There will always be more Spider-Man, you know, content, and we will see more lizard, you know, in there eventually, so it's all good. But yeah, with this, that, those, and the other things, man, I guess, that's that. Right on, and there you go. So thanks for watching the video. I hope you liked it as much as I did making it. Also, feel free to check out the source material that I featured in this video. And if you want to leave a comment on anything you may have liked or things I might have missed in this, you know, feel free to do so. Or anything else, you know, just to say hi. That's cool too. And other than that, you know, have a great day. Thanks.